But when I walked by, that particular group of folks were standing there peacefully behind police barricades, well off of the plaza. And I waved to them, gave them the thumbs up, pumped my fist to them, and thanked them for being there. And they had every right to do that.
But after what happened, do you regret that at all?
No, because I don't know which of those protesters, if any of them, those demonstrators, participated in the criminal riot. And I think it's a slur on the thousands and thousands, tens of thousands of people who came to the Capitol that day to demonstrate peacefully, to lump them in with the criminal rioters and say, oh, you're all basically the same. It's all just the same thing. You know, throughout all last summer, we heard over and over, it's important to distinguish between the peaceful protesters and the BLM protests and the rioters. I agreed with that then. I said that then. I think the same is true of those on January 6th. The tens of thousands of folks who came to D.C., the overwhelming majority of whom were peaceful. Don't try to censor, cancel, and silence me here. You raised the issue.
Senator,
so if you raised the issue, you've got to listen to the truth.
Don't try to censor, cancel, and silence me here, says Josh Hawley, during a live stream where he is the only participant and was invited by the outlet that he's accusing of silencing him. You literally won't find a better summary of the Republican Party encapsulated into just a few seconds than that. Because keep in mind, the GOP needs to keep alive this idea that they're the victims, that they're aggrieved, and that the evil Democrats are colluding with big tech and the media to gain some unfair advantage on Republicans. What they don't seem to acknowledge is that Fox News, a right-wing outlet, is the most watched news outlet on cable. What they don't seem to acknowledge is that Ben Shapiro's Daily Wire, a right-wing outlet, had almost 2 times the engagement of any other publisher this month on Facebook. Conservatives spend all this time wailing about how they don't have a platform, and they're doing it from the biggest platforms in the United States. And that's to say nothing of the fact that Republicans as a party actually represent far fewer people than Democrats, and yet somehow manage to find themselves either tied or in the majority. The US Senate just barely has a 50-50 split, even though Senate Democrats represent nearly 42 million more Americans than Senate Republicans. In fact, the last time that Senate Republicans actually represented more Americans than Democrats was in 1996, and yet Republicans held majorities in the chamber for most of that time anyway. So if anyone's voice is being underrepresented or silenced or censored, I can assure you that it's not the Republicans. And if you needed just one more example of this blatant hypocrisy by complaining about big tech, here's a tweet by Josh Hawley hawking his new book and saying, quote, "The corporate media and the woke mob don't want you to read this book. They tried to cancel it. They failed. 1 week until publication, order here." And there's the link right there to Amazon, posted from his Apple iPhone onto the Twitter app. That Josh Hawley is proving that he's not being silenced by virtue of using every platform he's complaining he's being barred from and lining his pockets in the process is just about the best metaphor for his BS that you could possibly find. But Josh Hawley's own delusions of censorship aside, what's even more damning is that when asked if he regrets this infamous photo of him holding up his fist in solidarity with the protesters on January 6th, he actually defends it. So that we're clear, this group of peaceful protesters would eventually storm the Capitol, where at least 5 lives would be lost. Not to mention anything about the fact that the lives of elected officials were put in immediate danger. And not just Democrats either, the protesters were literally looking for Mike Pence and Mitt Romney, all because those people had been brainwashed by Trump and his mouthpieces that the election was stolen and that anyone who refused to toe that line in either party would become a target. Only seconds and feet separated a funeral for a Republican senator or a vice president. And yet Hawley is out here defending this crowd. And I know I've repeated this 100 times, but since the GOP is hellbent on trying to manifest this alternate reality that the election was stolen, I will keep repeating how we know it wasn't. Trump had 65 court cases to prove that it was stolen, including in front of at least 8 judges who he himself appointed. That didn't work. Bill Barr's DOJ admitted it wasn't stolen. The Department of Homeland Security's cybersecurity unit admitted it wasn't stolen. Republican governors admitted it wasn't stolen. And Republican secretaries of state admitted it wasn't stolen. Right-wing news networks who cried conspiracy about voting machines have since issued public retractions conceding that their claims were baseless. And to this day, we still do not have a single piece of evidence that the election was stolen, other than the fanatical ravings of a desperate man-child who's too thin-skinned and petty to accept the fact that he lost by a margin that he himself called a landslide when he beat Hillary Clinton by that same margin in 2016. This entire disinformation campaign is the result of his inability to accept the fact that he's a loser. So Josh Hawley can shamelessly try and rewrite history, but the truth is right in front of us, and it's not going to change just because they're desperate to pander to a base of people who've been lied to on a daily basis by politicians who view their own voters as nothing more than suckers and marks. To see more videos like this, don't forget to subscribe. And for a deeper dive, check out my podcast, No Lie with Brian Tyler Cohen, where I discuss the week's top stories and interview major players in the world of politics, like Vice President Kamala Harris, White House Press Secretary Jen Psaki, Elizabeth Warren, Chuck Schumer, Katie Porter, Pete Buttigieg, Nancy Pelosi, and many more. Again, that's No Lie with Brian Tyler Cohen, available anywhere you listen to podcasts.